This is going to be short and unedited. First of all, I need to issue a correction, an apology to Vahagraphy. He's not using affiliate links. Although he was like, where's the Z2, the Z3, the Z7, 3, 4, something like that. And at the end, the fans of the Z6 ended up paying $6,500 for a camera. Incidentally, though, I would hire Vahagraphy to shoot my wedding because he uses lights. Do not hire any photographer who is not using speed lights and strobes. Which leads me to this comment. If 3D Pop was the end-all be-all, photography manufacturers will push for that. Absolutely. And then, of course, you would have problems. If you don't know what you're doing, you're going to end up with really awkward ratios in the image. And on the print, most of these areas, the blurry ones, they're going to look like dark mud. Not attractive at all. And then, of course, you will have people calling customer support. This is Bob from Indiana. My lens stopped popping yesterday because people do not know these concepts. And let's go to this one. I would like to know if Zeiss 50 Zonar has micro contrast and pop. These two things are completely different things. You know what micro contrast is? Sharpness.
If you have, if you look, for example, for the 10 line pairs per millimeter, the 100% contrast is black and white is white, and between that is everything. And if you have 40% contrast, here in this case, the white is not really white and the black is not really black, it's gray, and then you have 40%. The equation for that is in this direction, black minus dark, bright minus dark, and divided by bright minus black. So in reality, I need to highlight, in reality, most objects are not black and white in total.
And because we are talking about color photography, for our purposes, I gave the definition over here. The level of tonal separation, color accuracy, and accutance. Accutance means basically sharpness, the visibility of different areas of contrast. And in this example over here, the left one is poor micro contrast and filled with chromatic aberrations. The right one has no chromatic aberrations, it's excellent micro contrast. But at the same time, the image on the left has more pop, although the micro contrast is terrible, than the image on the right, that has the good micro contrast. And that's just because I closed down the aperture over here. Different aperture. So these two things, pop and micro contrast, are unrelated. If you want to know how to shoot dimensional images with any lens, not just Zeiss and stuff, check out this video, the first part only. Game Buster. Enhance depth perception in photos by changing the hue. Well, basically, if you get the correct tonality separation of colors, and I posted that recently here in this video.
Depth to the image where I don't think any other prep material would have that kind of, not just luminosity, but almost seems physically deep, you know. I've had people at gallery openings even kind of go like this to make sure you haven't glued something on the top of the print. When you get exactly the right color balance, and then even the slight opposite colors, let's say in the veins of green on a green leaf, will start to pop, you might say, or become more luminous.
And that's when you know you've got it.
Yeah, that's when you know you have it.
This is not from a backlit computer monitor. This is a detail from the actual print. It is a small detail from this print. But I also have an example from my own editing of a viewer's picture, because it's not about hue. Forget the hue. Forget it completely. Delete it. It's about white balance and good color separation. And in this video over here, I took a viewer's photo, this, the correct colors, and even the sharpness increased by itself without me affecting it, because beforehand, it was just a yellow mess. Look at the wall behind those people. If you watch this video, you will say, is it really that simple? Because I only did two things. No brushes, no curves, nothing. Even the cheapest software can do that. And here's a comment. I was not aware that anybody had ever said something like that, because everybody else says the opposite. Apochromatic lenses take half the bokeh. Well, if your bokeh is chromatic aberrations, then it's not real bokeh. Have you ever seen bokeh from an apochromatic lens? So this is not good? Middle of the day, the sun goes straight down, you can see it. EXIF data, straight out of camera, raw file, unedited. Not good. Chief Tele 08. Now I understand you're on a budget here, and with crop cameras. Sure at low ISO, forget all this DXO and stuff like that. I actually have videos in this channel proving that they destroy micro contrast and alter the image significantly. Go to my search field and type in topaz, two or three videos, watch them. As far as lenses, I made this video 5 years ago, and it's a slideshow of old cars. It's in 4K, and half of the images were shot with the D850 and the 24-70 Tamron, and the other half with the D500 by my daughter, and the 16-80 2.8E. It is a lens that I highly recommend for crop camera. It has distortion like all mid-range zooms, but it's very easily correctable because it's very smooth distortion. And the bokeh on that little crop lens, these are raw files as you can see. Fantastic. Both front and back bokeh. Personally, I did not expect that it would be that good. I mean, look at this. I bought it as a convenience lens. Dynasty UK, real pros use either beat up gear or very expensive rented gear, correct. Hobbyists always spend a lot more money because they don't know what they're doing. It's like my old boss, he had a gigantic stove. He was only using a tiny little part of it and he hardly knew how to cook. But he wanted to learn. So instead of going to a cooking school or really learn step by step how to make even simple recipes, the first thing he bought was a gigantic stove that not even 5-star chefs have. And I have to say something really important here. Normally, a professional cook or chef, he goes to school and he learns nutrition, how to store food, combinations and all that. In America, everybody who crosses the border is a chef. And that is why you go to the average American restaurant, the food is very heavy, unhealthy, sometimes you even get poisoning, they don't know how to store it, they don't know how to cook it, it's a terrible thing. Let's go to the next comment, the 3D effect of the Distagon. Well, here is your video to watch after the introduction, is less than 9 minutes. And it's the study of the same picture with the Distagon and with a Nikon 28. Much more important than that, and this channel is the only one that talked about this very fundamental issue that all the artists know. Key reason to print your images is to find the true size of an image, because they look different if they're small or if they're large. For example, bokeh looks really sharp in a small image, in a small screen, or in a small print. But bigger, it looks like it was actually shot. And I have said in past videos many times, know the size of your print before you take the picture. In this video over here, know the size of the picture before you shoot. But there is a fundamental problem with YouTube. Nobody watches the old videos because they think that a photography channel is like a news channel. So old videos are old news. And this is not the case. And that is why the so-called creators, we are not creators. At any rate, they try to entertain and amuse the public every time, their viewers, with a new thing that's out there, even if it has no value. It's like attention grabbing on steroids. Having said all that, this channel will not review or talk about lens or cameras anymore, unless it's incidental. I got many viewers recently because of lens talk. I have covered this subject in detail in older videos. Check the playlists. This channel is organized in playlists. But I cannot handle that many viewers, especially those who have not done valid research and read the manual of their cameras to begin with. You know, lenses are not miracle devices. They're just transparent glass. And that's why I say, print. Print your images. See what you're really doing. A photograph is a document, and it has limits, like any document has. It's not just an electronic file that spreads all over the place without limits. And within those limits, you have your items, and the composition of these items, how they're placed, that is your job.
Because liberty, la liberté, it's a strict frame of reference with all the variations inside the frame. But liberté is not contradictory.
The channel will go back to its intended content, and a lot of you are not going to like it. Some may even find it offensive, and it's going to be personal, and it's going to be so different that it will be unrecognizable for a photography-related channel. That's all I had to say. Thanks a lot. Bye.